Hi. My name's Duke. Happy Thursday. Happy October. Happy Autumn. I haven't streamed in a while. I wanted a game I could just kind of play and chill out and not really have to worry about my commentary too much. I only talk to people, like, a lot, twice a month, if that. I don't talk to anybody at work. I don't talk to anybody at the grocery store because I use the self-checkout. About every other week, I hang out with some friends. And even when I do that, I mean, it's not like I'm a chatterbox or anything. So, you know, sitting and talking consistently for an extended period of time is something you kind of have to practice. And I am out of practice, so... hence, playing this racing game. So the music is the Sonic Rush soundtrack. I'm going to be playing on a server with 63 people. If anyone watching has this game and wants to play, I will be on the Full Speed Mania Beginner server. And all of the servers have, not copyright legal music. So to hopefully prevent any copyright strikes on YouTube, I will be listening to my own music. This whole soundtrack is on YouTube, so YouTube shouldn't complain about it. Although I have gotten issues with content ID matches for video game music recently, which is really annoying. Let me know if this is too loud or anything. I have a brand new computer, so I had to redo all of my settings and everything. This game has, or this game claims to have, built-in Twitch streaming. But I tried it and it didn't work. Like, it sent out the notification, but the actual stream didn't work. Which, if you follow me on Twitter, was probably annoying because there were a lot of false positives, a lot of false notifications. JustRep says everything is kind of loud. Like, me? Am I too loud as well? Because I can turn everything down. Or do you just mean the music? Hang on a sec. I don't have my Be Right Back graphic, so I have to do this. Alright, how's that? Let me know if this is any better, if you can still hear me. Yeah, this will be the most unprofessional of streams. I just need to kind of get my groove back. I was as loud as the music went down a bit. Okay. Weird, okay. I mean, this is a new sound card and everything, so it might be, okay, let me tweet this all a little bit. Alright, how's this? I turned the music down, or the music/game audio down to 75, and I turned myself down to 10%. Is this acceptable? I really should have, like, recorded test videos and stuff beforehand, but I kind of wanted to just jump into it, you know? It's like... Music is good. Okay, what about me? I sound the same. Weird. Alright, how about now? Is that any better? Hopefully, hopefully this will do it. I don't know. Oh, I'm just going to jump into it. If it's unbearable, then let me know. So I went with Sonic Rush soundtrack because I wanted something that conveys a good sense of speed. So the average player's level on this ladder is higher than mine, which is good. I don't want it to be too high. I don't want it to be very difficult. These servers, I don't even have enough points to play on, which I've never seen that before. It doesn't sound like my mic is going down at all. Hang on. Alright, I turned my mic down to 40%. How's that? Any better? When I have the itch, I don't want to waste time tinkering with settings. Yeah, exactly, Galen. It's like kind of like a roller coaster. Like, if I spend too much time thinking about it, then my anxiety gets the better of me, and I talk myself out of it. So, I just kind of jump in willy-nilly. Just Rock says good. Okay, I'm going with that. So, like I was saying, I want a difficult track or a difficult server, but not too difficult. So I would jump in here. I haven't actually tested this with OBS, so hopefully my frame rate is okay. Should be okay. This computer is considerably better than my old one, but I still don't really know the nuances of my exact hardware settings. Okay, so apparently, so there's a little splash screen that the person who made this track put in there. You can just hit a button to skip past that. This soundtrack, by the way, was composed by the same person who did the Jet Set Radio game soundtracks, which those are also pretty good soundtracks. Okay, so in this game, in this mode, I'm doing time attack mode, which is what the server is all the time, as far as I know. My goal is to finish the track with as good a time as possible. So I'm not actually racing these people. These people are all playing at the same time as me, but as you can see, my car just goes right through their cars, and we don't actually interact with each other in any way. There's usually a chat room, but I have that turned off because there's never anything good going on in the chat room, in my experience. And you can honk at each other. That's my horn button. That's what it sounds like. I don't know if you can hear that over the music or not. Basically, it's very, very speedrunner-esque in that I'm just trying to basically learn the tracks and do them over and over again and try to improve my time a little bit every time, every attempt. I used to play on a server called Giant Bomb Unofficial Classic, which is the a fan server run by fans of the website GiantBomb.com. That server is no longer there, which kind of sucks because I played that server a lot and I learned a lot of the tracks pretty well. And I'm assuming a lot of those tracks are also on this server, but there's also a bunch of stuff I'm not familiar with. So, let's see, my last stream was what, in July? That was when I did my last FTL stream. Quite a bit's happened since then. Like I said, I have a new computer, and the power supply in my old computer died. And rather than putting more money into a crappy 7-year-old computer, I did something I've been meaning to do for a while, and just upgrade my whole system, or replace it, I guess. And it's pretty good. I can get most games, most games I've tried, I can usually get 60 frames per second running in 1080, which is nice. It's nice to finally be able to play games kind of the way they're meant to be played, like modern games. Of course, I haven't tried like Crysis 3 or any like huge graphical powerhouses like that, but mostly I'm just happy I'll be able to play Fallout 4 in native resolution. By which I mean 1080p, the same resolution as my TV. And hopefully that game will come out in a month, and I will be able to play it and enjoy it. I'm a little skeptical that it's actually coming out the way everything gets delayed these days. Every AAA game, anyway. Either delayed or launch is broken. One of the two. So Fallout 4 actually coming out on time and being good is like kind of a stretch. Hopefully it happens. I'm optimistic. And of course, with a better computer, I will be able to stream better games. Like for this game, I could barely play on my old computer in 720. I mean, I'm playing in 720 right now, but the frame rate's fine and actually playable. On my old computer, if I tried to stream this game, I would probably have to knock the window size down to like, I don't know, whatever by 320. Which would just be unplayable, or deal with like 15 frames per second, which you don't want to play a racing game at 15 frames per second. Oop. I accidentally hit respawn again. There are two respawn buttons in this game. There's one that takes you to the beginning of the track, and one that takes you to the last checkpoint. And the checkpoint one, I usually don't use that because the way these tracks are designed, see, like, at this checkpoint, there's no way I'm going to have enough speed to make this jump. And several of the tracks are designed like that, so you're usually better off just restarting from the beginning. I mean, you want to do that anyway because it resets your time. You don't want to crash and have that affect your time on the track, although I'm so bad at this game, or at these tracks anyway, I'm lucky to even be able to finish them. Like, I think this is the third time I've made it to this checkpoint. Okay, good, good, okay, looking good. As you can see, it goes in the first person on, shit. See, this is what happens when I respawn at the last checkpoint. I try to drive up this ramp and it's not going to happen. Yeah, I usually count myself fortunate, especially if it's the first time I've played a track, which, let's see, there's a way to, okay, see, it has PB here, that's personal best. As you can see, I've never actually finished this track before, so either I played it before and wasn't able to finish the track, or I've never played this track before, which explains why I can't finish it now, and that's time. So I finished 0th out of 61. You can see all of the people here. I'm in good company. A lot of these people couldn't finish this track. That was a hard one. In fact, only the 31 best players were able to finish. Well, that's not true. Some of them might have finished it, but they just didn't get any points for it. So this is a song that would be playing if I wasn't worried about content ID. So if you like, you can look up that song and see what it sounds like for the full experience. I actually haven't listened to this soundtrack since I played Sonic Rush on the DS, which was years and years ago. I remember enjoying it a lot, and I remember it being fairly energetic, which is why I went with it. Oh, hey, what's up, Levant15? Welcome. Welcome to this most unprofessional of streams. I'm really bad at this game, and I'm not that great at talking. You didn't miss much, Private Steve, just me kind of jabbering. Like, I have no idea if this game is of interest to anyone. I enjoy it. I'm not usually a big fan of racing games, but this one, this is the kind of racing game that I like. It's very arcadey. You know, all of the cars behave exactly the same. There's no... you don't have to worry about what car you're driving. You know, obviously it's arcadey because there are loops and corkscrews and speed zones and you're flying all over the place. The kind of racing game I don't like is the super realistic one where you're just kind of driving on a normal road that might appear in real life somewhere. Like, what's the point of that? Like, I like this, I like Mario Kart, and I like RC Pro-Am. RC Pro-Am probably doesn't count. Any racing game where you don't either go upside down or fire missiles at people isn't something I want to play. Like, I guess, like, I don't care about cars in real life. I don't drive myself, and I have zero interest in cars or driving. But I guess if people do drive, like, they might play Forza or something. Forza or Gran Turismo or whatever, to replicate the experience of driving like a real live car extremely fast, and like since they drive themselves, they're familiar with that feeling, and shit. That was a pretty good run for a while. Let's see if I can restart it at a checkpoint. There's a nice speed boost here. So yeah, I can understand why someone will play Forza or something, you know, from that perspective. Nah, it's not gonna work. Restart. But me, I just like going really fast and doing crazy jumps and loops and stuff and throwing turtle shells at people. That's my kind of racing game. And I got into this game originally because because I watched Jeff Gerstmann play it on Giant Bomb, and